In this video, I'll guide you through how to add file upload and download features to a Blazor web app. We'll create a feature that allows users to upload CSV files to import data into our database. Additionally, we'll add a download button for users to retrieve all the data in a CSV format. Now, let's begin the implementation process. I have set up a Blazor web app project for this demonstration. In the program.cs class, I have included the necessary dependency service for connecting to a SQL Server database. Within the data folder, you'll find our dbcontext class along with an entity class named product. The product entity class comprises four properties: ID, product code, product name, and price. For those who are interested in accessing the final project source code, it is available on our Patreon page. Let's navigate to the products page within our application. As you can observe, we have incorporated a table to display the list of products. Since there are no products currently available, it displays no products added. Now, we'll proceed to implement the import and export functionalities on this page. To facilitate CSV upload and download, we'll install a library specialized in handling CSV files. We are installing a library called CSV Helper, renowned for its efficiency in CSV read and write operations. We'll enhance the product class by adding attributes necessary for CSV read-write operations. Since the ID field isn't required in the CSV file, we can ignore it. We'll assign a custom CSV column name to the product code property. Additionally, custom CSV column names will be provided for the product name and price properties. Let's proceed to the products page razor component. Currently, you can view the existing design and code implemented for displaying the products table. I'll now integrate an input file element just above the table, enabling users to select a CSV file for import. Additionally, I'm including a button in the card header to facilitate the download of products. In the code section, I'm establishing a method named handleFileUpload, which should accept input file change event arguments as parameter. I'll designate this method for the onChange event of the input file element. Furthermore, I'm creating another method named downloadProducts. Let's associate this method with the onClick event of the download button. We'll commence the implementation of the handleFileUpload method. Firstly, we'll verify that e.file is not null. For simplicity, let's assign that object to a variable named file. We can instantiate an object of CSV configuration specifying invariant culture as the culture info parameter value. Additionally, we'll set the hashHeader record property to true. However, if your CSV file doesn't require the first row as a header, you can set it to false. Subsequently, we'll utilize a stream reader to open and read the stream from the file. At this point, we can assign the max allowed size parameter if necessary. By default, it will only allow 500 KB. If you need to upload larger files, you can assign the maximum allowed size. We need to specify the size in bytes. I'm providing a value that is approximately 2 MB. Additionally, we can utilize CSV reader providing the stream reader and culture info as parameters. Now, we can retrieve the products using the getRecordsEasing method of the CSV reader object. Having obtained the list of products, let's add them to the database using the addRangeEasing method. Subsequently, we'll save the changes using the saveChangesEasing method. To ensure the table data is refreshed, we'll reload the products. Furthermore, I'll display an alert message using JS Runtime. For further information on JS Runtime and other Blazor components, you can refer to our Blazor tutorial playlist. The URL is available in the video description. Let's proceed with implementing the download functionality. Similarly, we can create the CSV configuration object. Next, I'm utilizing a memory stream object. Then, I'll create a text writer object by providing the memory stream as the parameter. We'll use the CSV writer next, providing the text writer and CSV configuration as parameters. Afterward, let's utilize the CSV writer's WriteRecordsAsync method to convert the list of products to CSV content. Following that, we can fresh the text writer. Subsequently, we'll set the current position of the memory stream to the beginning using the seek method. Next, we can create an object of the .NET stream reference using the memory stream. Then, using the JS runtime, we'll invoke a JavaScript method named downloadFileStream. Currently, this JavaScript method does not exist, but we'll create it shortly. We'll also pass the file name and the stream reference as parameters. In the add.razor component, let's define the JavaScript method. We'll name it downloadFileStream, matching the name provided in the download function. It should accept the file name and the CSV content stream reference as parameters. You can simply copy the script from the source code available on our Patreon page. Here, we are creating a blob object and initiating a client-side download. The blob data will be temporarily stored in the client browser. Let's execute the application and evaluate the functionalities. On the products page, you'll now notice the presence of upload and download options. Let's proceed to test the upload functionality by attempting to upload a file. I prepared two CSV files for testing purposes. Let's proceed by uploading the first file, and you'll notice an alert message confirming the successful import. The added products are now populated in the table. Here is the content of the CSV file we have just uploaded. Additionally, I'll showcase the data in SQL Management Studio, where you can see all the five products. Now, let's proceed to upload the second file. Once again, we received a successful alert message and the products are added to the table. These are the three records we have uploaded now. Let's proceed to test the download functionality. You will find that the CSV file has been successfully downloaded. Now, let's attempt to open it in Excel. Upon opening, you'll observe that all the products we uploaded are displayed in the CSV file. I hope you now have a clear understanding on how to implement file upload and download functionality in a Blazor web app. If you found this video helpful, please consider liking, sharing, and subscribing to the channel. Thank you for watching, and I look forward to seeing you all in the next video. Happy coding!